So I'm trying to say to you that if you understand these mechanisms that are coming, the present doesn't look too good. The present only looks good because we don't know what the potential of the future is. It's just like your grandfather when he got his little sewing machine that he worked with his feet and the pump that brought the well water up. He lit a cigar and he says, this is it. But you had to go down before that and get the water from the river, bring it into the buildings and pails with a brace across your shoulder. And when they made that thing, somebody said, no, they've gone too far, even with the pump. So today you just turn on the faucet and you got the water right there. But where is all this going? What is this doing for man? And what enables us to get out of these ruts that we're in? By looking at the present world and say the present world has this and so on, but it isn't the best of all possible worlds. You have to get away from that idea of utopia. Even if we went out and built the world that I want to build, that would be the beginning of the next phase. Because 10 years into that world, the kids that grow up in that system will look at that world and all the old fucking Fresconian building that were around. They're out. Here's the new way. There's no utopia, no finality. Man has an infinite journey into change. So the idea of thinking of an ideal world where there's no war, that's good. That's only the beginning of the next phase. So people become very different, their values become very different, and that's what ought to be discussed at schools a lot, about inquiry, about thinking things out, about changing your mind. In fact, we say that one measure of sanity is your ability to change your mind, to be open enough to hear new things. And normal people who want to get married and have a family, a little house and country with chickens, that's a fixed set. And once you get that, you're dead. And once you get your house and country with chickens, your two favorite horses that you like to ride, if this is your best of all possible world, from that day forth, if you stagnate, your kids undergo change and you never understand them. So I say, get your house in the country with chickens. Get your horses, but read and listen to ideas so that you're programmed continuously, you're updated. That's why people become obsolete. They become obsolete because they arrive at a certain value system and they belong to the American Legion or the Turkish American Club. What does it do? Perpetuates Turkish-American values. You get together with Negro studies and they start growing their long hair again. Now this is going backwards. Your Negro says, well, goddamn, I'm proud of my heritage. And now you can't see the movie screen when he sits in front of you. And there's things they can't do. The point is, not heritage that you're interested in. You're interested in the functional aspects of people. Then they do another thing now. They make 27 parts in their hair in different directions. And that takes an awful long time. All day long, farting around with that. Now, they're stringing beads on each hair group, little tiny beads. This is really what we call an insufficient expenditure of energy in no direction at all. It goes nowhere. Excuse me. All I wanted to say to you is that there are tremendous changes. I'd like you to take this out with you tonight, that nothing is self-activating, that all things are acted upon by resonant forces. The Earth is held in its orbit, goes around the Sun. It isn't a free whirling body. The Moon is held in the gravitational bond of the Earth, and the whole solar system is obedient to other resonant forces. So when you get up and you say, well, what made that guy become an artist? It isn't one thing. Or what causes cancer? Or what causes heart disease? It's this blue dot here. It's hundreds of interacting variables.